now switch from utility to inverter and back.
Right.
And there's no harm doing it. I mean, I wouldn't do it over and over and over because the fridge, for example, might feel the difference, you know, that it's going from 50 cycles on the utility, the inverter is 50 cycles.
The
utility is pure sine wave power. The little inverter that we're using is a modified square wave. So it is not as pure a power supply. So that's another thing that you may have to switch over to the utility is if you have a very sensitive load.
Right.
Then you may want to switch over to the utility temporarily to have that. The other thing is if you have a planning a big outing or an event and you need more than 10 amps.
So the whole thing, that all the lights are going to be on, there's going to be a couple of computers.
And you want everything on and lots of stuff where you might have the alternate system will only give you a limited power capacity. It's a 1,000 watt inverter.
Right.
With a 2,000 watt surge capacity, which means you can have a very liquid motor can start up a temporary surge, but on a consistent basis, it can only supply 1,000 watts.
Right.
And
what's an indication of what would be 1,000 watts? I mean, is a fridge 1,000 watts or a light?
1,000 watt light bulbs is 1,000 watts.
Oh.
Who uses 1,000 watt light bulbs anymore?
Right.
A fluorescent fitting like this is 40 watts. So you could run 20 of these on that inverter without problem. The fridge probably runs at about 2 amps, which is about 200 watts. Right.
So you could actually run 5 fridges on the 4 panels that we have, technically speaking.
At the same time, on the inverter. How long? Now, if you put 5 fridges on, there's energy you measure in terms of power, load you measure in terms of power and energy.
Right.
Power is the magnitude of the load.
Right.
Energy is the duration of the load. So you could have 1,000 watt lights burning for 1 hour.
Right.
Or alternatively, a microwave oven for 1 hour, because that's about 1,000 watts. How would you get them over 1 hour? The energy that you gain from the roof, we're only going to get here in this project about 800 by 5 is 4,000 watt hours, which is 4 kilowatt hours in a day. So if you use more than 4 kilowatt hours in a day, then it means that you're not going to be harvesting enough energy to meet your needs.
To save the battery.
So the battery goes, it's going to fall and fall and fall, and eventually it's going to meet.
So if
you use less than that, the battery voltage will stay up, and the batteries will stay in good condition, and you won't need to go over to the earth.